Dear brothers and sisters, yesterday we have been considering two great qualifications, discrimination and the second, fearlessness or vairagya, or you may call it dispassion. And we also referred from the passages at the feet of Master, also passages from Vice of Silence and Light of the Path, because these three books are on the occult path, very, very important. So we have laid down the foundation for further qualifications. Discrimination is the first qualification. If you do not have the discrimination, if you do not have the right type of understanding, then vairagya is not possible. Vairagya or desirelessness or dispassion cannot be practiced forcibly. It must come of its own. Dispassion is the byproduct of discrimination. I repeat, dispassion or vairagya is the byproduct of discrimination. When there is a discrimination, then automatically dispassion state will come. When we know the futility of a thing, when we know the limitations of the thing, when we know the temporariness of the thing, when we know the usefulness of the things, then automatically it is gone, right? And we have also considered that on this spiritual path, you have to be relative, essential and non-essential, then less essential and more essential. Essential, less essential and more essential. Similarly, at the desireless level also, we also consider there are certain sects of desire which have to be totally eliminated, and there are some desires in the beginning, some desires which helps on this spiritual path, like desire which is within us, desire which is beyond us, desire to know, desire to become like the Master. Light of the Path says, in his presence, in the presence of the Master, all desires die, except the desire to be like him. So if this is the desire, that we want to become like teacher, we want to serve the humanity, though it is a desire, but it is a different type of desire. It will elevate you, it will help you. And finally, when you reach to a final state, then even this desire will go. Your service, your love, your is automatically. After considering all these two points, now we are on the third qualification, good conduct, or you may call it shat-sampatti. These things, good conduct, or shat-sampatti. Yes. These things are, you already know theoretically. So far as the theory is concerned, you know. We know discrimination, we have read many times, but we can't say that we are fully discriminated. We know what desirelessness is, but we can't say that we are desireless, fully desireless. At the feet of Master also says, we may say that we are pure at heart, we have no desire, we have no ambition, but our saying has no meaning. When Master will come and he will inspect our heart, if he finds it utterly clean and free from desires, then only is worth, correct? So these qualifications which we have been discussing, these are common things. So far as the informative knowledge is concerned, there is nothing new in it, but we are again and again emphasizing on it, again and again we are hampering on it, again and again we are trying to understand and live and go deeper and deeper. That's why there is a repetition. So don't take it that way. If you take that way, don't know what you are telling, discrimination, desirelessness, we already know. We do not know. Other day, I was talking, there are three types of person. I again repeat, it's a wonderful statement in the attitude of Master. One, those who know, and other, those who do not know. And Master says, there are the three types of person, third type of person, those who do not know. Actually, they do not know, but they think that they know. They are most dangerous persons. So let us not come into third category. If we know, it's okay. Part of the understanding is there. But if we do not know, it's also not bad. Don't feel guilty. There are many persons though who do not know. If you are child, they are growing, they are going towards greater and greater perfection. So there is nothing to feel guilty. If you have desires, if you have some ambitions, if you have some faults and shortcomings, don't feel guilty. It's a part of the life. But be aware of it. Be aware of it. Know it. Sometimes I become angry, sometimes I have some hatred emotion, sometimes I have some desires. So let us be very much watchful, aware and alert, right? Then we will be like a watchdog to our own lower self. It will be helpful to us. But regarding not good conduct, you know why this good conduct or this Shat Sampatti has been kept on third place, why not only first place? Whereas in other school of thought, the good conduct or Shat Sampatti or Yam Niyam or Panch Sheel or Ten Commandments are only top of the first. Correct? In Buddha says, Panch Sheel, don't steal, don't injure your friends. So many things. Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya, Abhyanga, Soch, Santosh.